I'm eating all the specialities of Andro in one plate. There's the pork and there's the wine, and I've got to find out how this is locally brewed here. Apparently, they do it in their backyard. Right after lunch, that's where I'm going.
Like the people and their food, everything about Manipur is seeped in tradition, as is the brewing of rice, wine or beer, and is done, of course, by its women.
So this is actually the principal source of income for all of the families in Andro. And this is a tradition that has been passed down through many, 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 many generations, from the elder women of the house to the younger women of the house. Because it's only the women that make it, as we know. Ah, thank you. Oh, yum. What is this?
Atingba.
Atingba. Atingba. Is that rice bill? Rice bill? Delicious. What a wonderful way to wait. I'm going to drink some rice bill while I'm waiting for my rice wine to brew. Talk about mixing drinks. Mmm. Yum. So what I've understood, I think, is that the wine is brewing in the main pot, which is on the fire. Then there's a sieve in the middle and a pot of cool water on top. And as it sort of bubbles up, it kind of distills through this lovely pipe into this delicious pot here. Another interesting fact is that the people of Andro are one of the oldest communities, one of the oldest Mai Tai communities of Manipur. And that's the reason when the whole state converted to Vaishnavism and it became the official state religion, these people didn't convert to Hinduism, which is why rice wine and beer is so popular here. And all of you that come to Manipur, do not forget to come to Andro. Chin chin!
After a high-spirited afternoon in Andro, I decided to travel a little further to be inspired even more by the highs that these women of Manipur have reached.
Handloom is the primary cottage industry of the state and a popular family business. So much so that almost every household owns a loom, and the women do the weaving, and also traditionally both the commissioning and retail, which not only gives them a control over the cottage industry but also have a huge confidence because of the financial independence it gives them.
Weaving dreams while spinning yarn. Now that's got to be a woman's touch. Chatter, laughter, gossip. These hand-weaving centres form a big part of the socio-cultural tradition of the people of Manipur. And like Ima Market, it is here where ideas and information are exchanged. And this is what helps keep the women aware and empowered. And as with every great tradition, this gorgeous craft has its very own fascinating origin story.
So Pramila has just told me a really interesting origin story. Apparently, Pathoibi, a goddess, once saw a spider weaving a really intricate fine web, and that's where she got the idea of handloom weaving from, and that's where it all began. Such a cool story. Manipur is a testimony to the amazing spirit of its women. And in this region, despite hardship and turmoil, it is their abiding grace that prevails. The women here are an example for everyone.